Good morning, student. So, student, in the last video and in the last class, we read about the computer fundamental knowledge, something and related to the previous class. Okay, but now today we will read about the software. Computer software. So, and your chapter is Know Your Computer Software. Yes, student. And your last, in your last class, that's your topic related with the Know Your Computer hardware, but in this class change your topic. So your topic is Know Your Computer System. So student, you know what is software? So software plays a vital role in computer system by creating a bridge between the computer hardware and computer users. Yes, is it clear? What is software? What is software? Software plays a vital role in computer system by creating a bridge between computer hardware and computer users. Okay, yes, student. So very simple definition. So in this chapter, your attention will be drawn to understand the computer software. So and function within computer system. Okay, so computer system have several types of software. So and their functionality is different. Yes, student. So there are several way, one mini sheet computer software and the user. So has to select the most appropriate mode of obtaining this software requirement. Yes, student. So and that is definition of software. So software is a vital role in computer system by creating a bridge between hardware and user, computer user. Okay, so software is creating a bridge. Yes, student. So and then after we will talk about the types of software. Yes, student. So you know that's major types of software. Types of software. So here are three major type software. Okay, student. So first, very important, system software. And then second, application software. Application software. And the last important software is communication software. Communication software. Okay, so computer software are of three main types according to the type of aids. functioning in the computer system. Okay, student. So, three types of software. So, you know, system software, student. So, system software is a collection of program. System software is a collection of program designed to operate the computer and control it. So, system software performs the basic function to start and operate the hardware component of the computer system. So, they instruct the computer how to operate its peripheral. In other words, system software deals with running the computer system or making it work. Okay, so system software serves as the interface between the user, the application, and software and the computer hardware, such as a printer, scanner, monitor, keyboard, etc. So system software is the provided by computer manufacturer or the independent software developers. So just example, COBOL compiler, Fortran, this is a system software. So system software are looks after the controlling computer peripherals, coordinate the functionality of the computer peripheral, and it also manages all the computer related resources. So system software can be divided into two parts. So that operating system and communication software. So system software already two types. First operating system and then utility software. Okay, student. So we will discuss first about the system software. System software. So system software divided in two part, operating system and then utility software. Utility software. So students, first of all, I will take the first system software, operating system. So you know that in an operating system are called OS. So an operating system is the software program that deals with the functioning of the computer and its peripheral. So it is the core software component of our computer. So it is an interface between your computer and outside the world. Okay, student. So this is a interface between your computer and outside the world. That's your computer plus outside the world. Student. Okay, so this is a interface between your computer and outside the world. Yes, and that next, you know, operating system, here are many type. Okay, student. Yes, operating system, many type operating system, so that first multi-user, multi-user, and then second multi-processing, so multi-processing, and third multi-threading or multitasking, maybe multi-threading and multi-tasking, and the next real time, real time, and next 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 GUI. Okay students, so there are 6 type operating system. So first, what is multi user operating system? So multi-user operating system enables multiple user to run program. So these types of operating system may be used for just a few people or 100 of them. Okay, so this is a multi-user operating system. And multi-processing, so multi-processing allows a program to run on more than one central processing unit at a time, and this can come in very handy in some work environment, so at school and events for some home computing situation, multi-processing. And multi-threading, so that's allow various parts of one program to be used. And then multi tasking, so this is little different, they make it possible to run more than one program at a time. Yes, so and then real time, so real time operating system are the time shared operating system that allows user to interact with computer. And GUI, that means graphical user interface. So graphical user interface operating system, user interfaces that employ pointing devices for input. Okay, so that's you know, pointing devices, just mouse is a pointing device example. So a mouse is an example of such a pointing device. And then, okay student, and then after we will talk about the micro operating system, Microsoft operating system, Microsoft operating system. You know student, you open the
student, mostly time you open the computer in the lab and in the at your home, so you will find that type windows, starting window, yes, on the desktop. So you know what is this logo of Windows, Microsoft Windows, yes, this one. So there are many types of operating system. So MS-DOS, MS-DOS and Microsoft, so that Windows 7, Windows 95, no, first of all, MS Windows 3.1 and after Windows 95, then after develop 98, okay, and Windows 8 operating system develop, so that after Windows ME, Windows ME and Windows XP, Windows XP, Windows Vista, okay. So this is a chain of developing operating system software, yes, and then after Windows 7, yes, student, and then Windows 8. So this is a developing operating system day by day. First of all, MS-DOS, and then Windows 3.1, and then after began Windows 98, Windows ME. So this is a operating system different type. And then after, and you know that system software two type, first operating system and then utility software. So then utility software. So what is utility software? So utility program are mainly intended as a helping aid and is provided by the computer manufacturer. So this program are also known as service program. So it perform a specific task usually related to meaningful computer, its devices or its program. Okay, so this is a utility software. So and main application software. So we will take the next software, application software. So you know how many type application software? System software. You know three type is type software. First system, then application, okay, and then communication. So system software complete, then after we will look on the application software. So application software allows user to store information, create content and media, access information and communication. Okay student, so many type application software. First, word processing software. Word processing software.
Okay, student. So, application software is a major type of software. So, software and it is also called as end user program. So, the software is used to edit text, number and graphics, and utilizes the capacities of a computer for the completion of task. Okay, student. So, first, word processing software, and second, spreadsheet software. And then third, database software. Database software, and then presentation software. Presentation software, and the last, multimedia software. Multimedia software, student. Okay. So, please note that application software. So, first of all, we will clear about the word processing software. So, word processing software, that is a word processor is a program used to type document, and document can be saved, closed, and can be opened. Okay, student. So then continue working on them. So this is the keyboard of word processor is similar to that of a typewriter. So but its capabilities extend for beyond the typewriter. For example, you don't have the press the return or enter key at end of every file in processing line. Okay, yes, so this is benefit of that software. So this is an example of the word processing software. Is a WordPad, then MS Word, Notepad. Okay, so this is a word processing software. You can create the file and document, okay, by this software. And then spreadsheet software. So you know, spreadsheet software are used to work with financial information. Spreadsheet software are used to work with financial information. So spreadsheet is a layout in numbered row and column. Yes. So where are the row and column intersect is a card. So that means, understand, student, we are talking about the which software you use already in the previous class. MS Excel. Yes, this software design, this type, many row, and here are many column. So you know, this one box is called cell. Okay, student. So this is a cell. So what is cell? Cell interact between the row and column. Okay.
which plays intersect between row and column, that's called cell. Yes. So the cell is referred to by the letter and number of intersection. So called the cell address. You know, here is A, B, not here, A, B, C, D, E, F, and here is 1, 2, 3. So suppose your cell is here, so your cell name is B2.
Okay, students? Yes. And then database software. So database is a collection of data. So the purpose of this software is to organize the managed data. So this is MS Access.
So MS Access is a
most example of the database software. And student, presentation software. So presentation software is a category of application software used to create sequence of word and picture. So then tell a story or help support a speech or public presentation of information. Yes. So the presentation can be viewed as a slide. Yes. Look this first slide, and then after comes to another slide by a click or by a press any function key. So that the display are in large monitor or on a projector screen. Okay, student. So very popular software for the presentation, MS PowerPoint. Okay, student. Yes. So PowerPoint is a example of presentation software. So used for the present any story and any file, any documents. And then multimedia software. So multimedia, so media players and real players are the example of multimedia software. So this software we allow the user to create audio and video. So the difference form of multimedia software are audio converters, players, burners, video encoders and decoders. So this is multimedia software watching for the video, okay, and audio. Video and audio. Okay, student. So clear. So and left only one topic, communication software. So we will discuss the next class. Okay, so please you read the all topic at your home. Okay, student, thank you so much.